Dear students, I am Shiva, faculty of physics. In this session, we will continue the previous topic with the help of key ideas, what we discussed at that time. So this is for 8th standard. So in this session, I will use the previous video or previous topic ideas to apply it. So suppose here you are seeing two charged particles, one is Q1, another one Q2. Both charges are separated by the distance r1. This is initial configuration or arrangement. But remember one thing, q1 is fixed. Okay, q1 is not movable, but q2 is movable. But one condition, we are reading this topic under electrostatics. That's why we need to maintain the motion of Q2 is in restricted manner. Suppose in this configuration I am saying this is the distance r1. After some time I am showing this is one more configuration, that is I am saying final configuration. At that time this is the distance r2. In the case of r1 distance or r2 distance, the Q2 is approximately maintained in the state of rest. Okay, why then we need to maintain rest? In order to apply or in order to satisfy the rules of electrostatics. But how we can maintain the state of Q2 in the state of rest? Actually, you can release Q2 freely. Q2 experiences repulsive force. Na? This is positive charge, this is positive charge. Both positive charges will experience some repulsive force, but this is fixed, so no chance for Q1 to move. But Q2 has a chance to move due to the force exerted by Q1. At that time, then what we need to do? We need to apply some force, that is external force, in the direction opposite to the electrostatic force. Electrostatic force acting on Q2 is rightward. The external force acting on the Q2 must should be in the leftward. Why? At that time only, if both forces are balanced, Q2 we are able to maintain in the state of rest, or we are able to maintain with negligible speed. Same case here also. Whenever it reaches this distance r2 with respect to q1, at that time also you are restricting the motion of q2 in this manner by applying the external force on the q2 in the opposite direction. Okay, means here and here it is in the state of rest due to the external force that is continuously balancing this f. Okay, now observe here carefully. In the previous topic or in the previous video, we studied the conservative force present. At that time, potential energy also there present. Here also you are seeing conservative force. Electrostatic force is conservative force. Under the presence of this electrostatic force only, you are changing the position of Q2 with respect to Q1 from R1 to R2. So position of the Q2 is changing under the action of conservative force, that is electrostatic force. That's why here we can say electrostatic potential energy is present. Now, how can we calculate that force? In order to calculate this value, so we will consider previous expression. So what is the previous expression? Delta U is equal to minus W. In the previous video, we studied this one as experimental result, where W is the work done by conservative force. Delta U is corresponding change in the potential energy. Now, what is the work done by the electrostatic force? So, work done by the electrostatic force, variable force or constant force? It is variable force. That's why we can use second key idea from our last video. So, here what we can write now with the help of that key idea, minus integral. So, position changes from R1 to R2. F, what type of force this is? Electrostatic force, okay, into dr. Here, electrostatic force direction, this is electrostatic force. So, what is the direction of electrostatic force? rightward generally we can take positive, na? That's why here I am using that sign is positive. Okay, suppose I am assuming Q2 lies at some general distance r from Q1. Assume Q2 is moving from the position of r1 to some general distance r. At that time, what is the value of this electrostatic force? Now we can write minus integral r1 to r2 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q1 q2 by r square into dr. Okay, so here what are the constants? 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q1 q2 both are constants. Now take these constants out. Now what we can write? Minus 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into q1 q2 integral r1 to r2 1 by r square dr. Okay, now perform the integration. So while performing the integration, what is the result? Minus, this is delta u. So delta u is equal to minus q1 by q2 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught into, so integral 1 by r square, what we can write? R power minus 2 plus 1 divided by minus 1 under the limits r1 to r2. Okay, so later substitute here, one time r with r2, again minus, one more time r with r1. Now what we can write? Minus q1 q2 by 4 pi epsilon naught into minus r2 power minus 1, minus 2 plus 1 minus 1, that's why minus of minus again plus r1 power minus 1. Okay, so again we can write minus q1 q2 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught. So here what we will write? Minus 1 by r2 plus 1 by r1. Okay, so send this minus sign inside of this bracket terms. Now what we can write again? 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into q1 q2 into 1 by 1 by r2 minus 1 by r1. So this is the change in gravity, change in electrostatic potential energy when the separation between q1 and q2 changes from r1 to r2. This is change. Suppose if you want to calculate absolute electrostatic potential energy, assume now yourself q1 q2, okay, both are separated by the distance r. At this time, what is the value of u? This is not difference, this is absolute value. How can we calculate the absolute value? In order to calculate that absolute value, so assume yourself initially q1 q2 are separated by the distance infinity. Okay, initially q1 q2 are separated by what distance? Infinity distance. Due to the action of the electrostatic force as well as under the presence of external force, you are maintaining the distance between q1 and q2 as r. At that time, what is the value of u? So initially we are saying, so here r1 is equal to infinity. Okay, we are assuming both are initially separated at what distance? Infinity distance. At infinity distance, do you have any electrostatic force? No. If electrostatic force is zero, automatically the potential energy also zero. That's why u is equal to zero. Okay, r2 is equal to r. So what is u? Uf. This is uy, na? Okay. So what is uf? Uf now assume as u. Now take this main expression. In this main expression, what is uf? Uf we can substitute as u. ui we can substitute as 0. So after this substitution, what we can write now? So substitute here uf minus uy, uf u, uy 0. So u minus 0 u is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into q1 q2 into, so r1 is equal to infinity, r2 is equal to r. So 1 by infinity term becomes 0. So 1 by r2 nothing but 1 by r. Okay, so this is what now for us absolute potential energy. But one thing here you need to remember, it is not mandatory to take the value of absolute potential energy at infinity. Sometimes in problems we can see some reference value is attached for this reference configuration. At that time its value may be either minus 10 joule, minus 30 joule, otherwise plus 20 joule, whatever may be that value. It is not compulsory again to take this value is always equal to 0. But what is the use of this reference configuration? With the help of this reference configuration, we are able to calculate the value of absolute potential energy, that is electrostatic potential energy. Okay, so this is the expression for the calculation of the change in the potential energy. This is the expression for the calculation of the change in the absolute potential energy for the two particle system. Suppose if you want to calculate the absolute potential energy for three particle system or four particle system, we can do same thing. So initially assume that three or four particles are lying at infinity, then try to group all of that particles to your desired choice of arrangement. At that time use the same formula to calculate the absolute potential energy, but each time you need to take one different pair. Suppose if you are taking the q1, q2, q3, so if you took q1, q2 one time, then don't repeat q2, q1 as one more time. So q1, q2 only allowed, q2, q1 again not allowed. Why? Different pairs only always you are allowed to take while using this formula to calculate the absolute potential energy if you are using it for more than two particle system. Okay students, this is today's lecture. I hope you understood this session well. In the next session we will meet with one more new concept. Thank you for watching.